We shall now incorporate forms authentication to our project. We have seen that we are able to store password in encrypted form. We have also seen how invalid user ID password and how the user is taken to a new page. Right now, we shall demonstrate how we can include forms authentication. As usual, my whole stress is always on the concepts. So I am taking it from the basic, nothing built in by Visual Studio. But you should be aware about forms authentication from your ASP.NET. Some familiarity with forms authentication is expected. But I am not using anything given to me by Visual Studio. So we'll start as if we are coding it all ourselves. Okay. For this, I'll remind that we created this whole story with the basic MVC template that is available when you create a new MVC project. When you create a project with the basic MVC template, then in your web.config, they add a line called authentication mode is forms, login URL is account by login. They add it because they add account controllers and all by default, but in this basic it is not added, but still you will find this line there. This basically tells the address of the login page. We'll start by rectifying this one first because our login page is different. Let us run our application to see what is our login page. Because that is the first thing that we should do. Click on login. This one in the address bar is the login page. It is inside the login area. We'll correct this one. So this is the first thing that you will keep in mind, that we have corrected login area by user. So in case the user is not authenticated, he'll fall to this page. Next thing, closing and saving this one. Now when the user successfully logs in, we are taking him to the welcome home page that we created. This is the opportune time where we should create an authentication cookie. If we had included a checkbox there, remember me, then that cookie would be stored permanently, and if it is not, then it should be stored temporarily. So we'll see how we create that cookie and how to ensure that it is stored permanently in response to this checkbox state. Okay, I'll write forms authentication. This I'll have to add a reference to the namespace, add resolve using system.web.security dot set auth cookie. So username is t dot, we'll refer the username by his email. Second password is create persistent cookie. So we don't have a checkbox in our current login form. If a checkbox had been there, then we should have read that checkbox and posted it true or false according to whether it is tick marked or not. Since no checkbox is there, we'll just not create a persistent cookie. This is one thing that you have to do. Just one line of code put here. Second, when you are going to the page where the user will ultimately be taken on authentication, the page is welcome page we added. Let us have a look at that page that is in views welcome, this one. The user comes to this page. Here I should show him his name. I'll write H2. This is not correct, I'm just writing it like anything. You are logged in as at the rate user dot identity dot name. This name will be picked from this name. When we set an auth cookie, we set a username. So this name will be picked from this one. This is one thing. I must go to the controller for welcome so as to write the authentication code there. Home controller, this is the welcome. Here I can write if user dot identity dot is authenticated, then you ask him to stay on this page, else forms authentication it will need a resolution resolve. I'll just scroll it into view in case it is not. Forms authentication dot redirect to login page. I'll do one thing. If not, so if user is not authenticated, then he'll be redirected to the login page. Otherwise, he comes to the current page where he is shown his name. Let us run it and see. Clicking on login. Username is z@z.com. His password is hoven login. So it works. z@z.com. Now in case I'll copy the URL, I'll close it so that the cookie is destroyed. I'll paste the URL and if everything is okay, I should be shuttled to the login page. Paste and it works. So this means my forms authentication is working. If you are familiar with the concepts of forms authentication, then I can go one step further also. We were writing this login URL here. It is also possible to write other default URL and other stories here. So you can make those additions here, in fact include roles also. So I haven't gone into those concepts, I haven't dug into those concepts. But basically what I've tried to explain you is that authentication can be easily integrated. You have to just check user identity is authenticated, redirect him to some other place, otherwise by default bring him back to your welcome page. And I also explained that if somebody tries to directly type the address of the welcome page, then he is shuttled back to the login page. Now, this was just one particular action that I tried to put authentication check on. But it is possible to write a customized authentication attribute. So that authentication is automatic, because some actions might require authentication, some might not require. There will be some pages which will be common to all users requiring no authentication at all, whereas some they will require authentication. So instead of writing so much of code, what we can do is we can create a custom filter so that we write something like here auth, and when I write auth, this particular action should not be allowed to be executed if the user is not authenticated. So this check will be automatically moved inside an auth attribute class. We'll learn the use of that in a later chapter. So we'll close it right now. Thanks.